we're going to go ahead and tour the Reno County Museum today. This is actually going to be my first time along with everybody. I've never been to this one. I've come by it several times. It's actually close to home, but I've actually never gone ahead and gone in. So let's go ahead and take a tour and see what all there is. All right, see you inside. I'm here at the Reno County Museum, and I'm here with David. I'm going to ask him a few questions of what does draw to people to the museum, and what things do people like to see and everything about the museum?
So the museum, we've been here since 1986. A lot of the things that people like to see are the very early stuff when people first started settling Reno County. Reno County is a big salt county. We're known for salt. So we have a lot of exhibits dedicated to salt. In fact, we're working on one right now. And in the future, the museum will look a little bit different, where we can show more of a comprehensive story of Reno County. Right now, each case is a different theme, and we only have some of the small items out, but we've got about 30,000 artifacts, and some of them are quite large. Yeah, we have appliances and farm implements, and a lot of those bigger items that obviously won't fit in a display case. So we're looking forward to being able to put some of that stuff out. That'll come soon.
Actually, my first time being here. Mm-hmm. I've actually lived here close to it, but it was actually my first time coming in. And it's really interesting. You guys change out exhibits mm-hmm. quite often, so yeah. There's always something new from what I can tell, from what I've heard on the radio and everything.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we try to change it out as often as we can. There's only four of us on staff, so sometimes we get caught in other events that we're putting on, and it doesn't change out as fast as we would like, but it will eventually get to the point where it's a lot easier to do. We also take volunteers all the time, so anybody who wants to volunteer, we'd love to have you. So.
Cool. I noticed a lot of different things as I walked around, the RV and everything that was built here.
Yeah, we actually have one of those being restored right now. Hopefully in the next couple of years we'll have it outside next to our claim house. And it's a really interesting piece of technology. It's kind of the precursor of a lot of the modern RVs, so to speak. And it had a pretty humble beginnings, but because of the nature of Reno County and the aircraft industry, they started making them here, and it's actually quite a cool piece of vehicle and automotive history.
Now here's an old Amish buggy. We still have a large Amish community out by Yoder. They still drive the horse and buggies around there. If they actually come to Hutch, most of them will drive a tractor in. Oh, Indian motorcycle. Old soda fountain. Can you imagine back in the 50s sitting in front of one of these? So what's one thing that you think I should actually definitely look at when I'm here?
So I think the Reno Is exhibit is our best right now. If you really want to get at the heart of all the different types of people that have lived in Reno County over the last 150 years, it's a really good place to start.
That's the one with all the photographs with each person, like the Dillon and Hutchinson and everything.
They are the, you can kind of think of it as a hall of fame, so to speak. And it starts from the very beginning with Hutchinson himself and then kind of runs all the way up till today. I think there's people that are as recent as 10, 15 years ago. And in the future, we designed it so that we could change them out as we went. So it's not just the same 17 people. It's everyone contributes in different ways. And so we want to honor all those people that contribute. And most of the people, in fact, I think all of the people in there are deceased. But in the future, we want to honor people that are still alive, people that are still contributing, some that have gone on to bigger and better things outside of Reno County. But they all came from here. They all did something to enhance how we live in this county. And so that's kind of what we like to do in that exhibit. And that's why I like it. Everyone in there is different. And it kind of gives you this nice comprehensive look.
We even have a kids section. David's going to show us in here real quick. The claim house. Fun, joy, lath and plaster.
Yeah, and that's the original lath and plaster too. It served a lot of purposes over the years, but most of this is still original. There's a little bit here and there that's not.
I was reading that it was first a small claim house so that they could get the property.
Yep.
Then from there it went to an addition after they built a bigger home.
Mm-hmm.
Then it became a wash house for them, and then it became a workstation.
Yeah, wood shop, basically. Yeah, we have a photograph of this building attached to the house when it was an addition, but we don't have any photos of it when it was a bathhouse or a workshop, unfortunately. But it's pretty neat to see it attached to a house.
And then from there, it got moved over here to a museum.
Yeah, they were enlarging K-96. I think it was K-96, one of the freeways that runs just south of here. It was either 50 or 96, and it was going to be destroyed if they didn't move it. And so they asked if the museum wanted it. We said yes, and the family paid to have it moved over here piece by piece, set it up, and it's been here ever since the early 90s, I think.
It said 1997, I think it was.
Yeah. Yep. So many dates in my head.
Oh, I imagine it's probably trying to remember everything.
Yeah.
So, well, thank you.
Yeah, my pleasure. Okay.
It's kind of interesting.
Yeah.